हेलो, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुनील कुमार. टुडे आई विथ हियर विद द लॉ ऑफ डिमांड, अजम्पशन एंड एक्सेप्शंस. द लॉ ऑफ डिमांड इज अ माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक लॉ दैट स्टेट ऑल अदर फैक्टर्स बीइंग इक्वल. एज द प्राइस ऑफ अ गुड्स और सर्विसेज इंक्रीजेज, कंज्यूमर डिमांड फॉर दैट गुड्स और सर्विसेज विल डिक्रीज एंड वाइस वर्सा. There is an inverse relationship between quantity demand and its price. There is a demanding of law refers to the direction in which quantity demanded change due to change in price. Law of demand is qualitative and not quantitative. It tells us the change in price leads to change in demand, but does not tell us how much that would be changed. We can see in the figure, in the diagram. In this figure, the D is the demand curve, which is in slope position. It shows the quantity of the goods that the customer would like to purchase at every possible price. When price is P1, quantity demanded is Q1. When price is P1, the quantity demanded is P1. And in this sequence, when price falls to P2, the quantity demand is, what would be the quantity demand? That would be the Q2. Falling price lead to increase in the quantity demand. Demand curve generally slope downward to right, downward to right, left to right. And it is negative slope, downward to right, and it has negative slope, which indicate that the quantity demanded increase as a price decrease. A point on the demanded curve indicate maximum quantity that a customer will buy at a given price, or we can say that demanded curve show the maximum prices a consumer will pay for different quantity, different goods as per unit of the time. This is the explanation of demand of law, law of demand. Now I am going to explain to assumptions of law of demand. Law of demand is based on a certain assumptions which would be in 9 or 10 terms. That are the no changes in income of consumer, no changes in price of product, no changes in quality of product, no close substitute of the commodity, the price related commodities remain at the same. There is no change in customs. There is no change in taste and preference of the consumers. The size of population remain the same. The climate and weather condition are the same. The tax rates and other fiscal measures remain the same. These are the assumptions which are necessary for the adopting law of demand. And now I am going to explain exceptions of the law of demand. What is the exceptions? What are the exceptions which are not following the law of demand? Law of demand is inferior goods. The law of demand does not apply in the case of inferior goods. Use of inferior goods is generally look down upon. When income increase, people migrate to use superior goods. When price of inferior goods decrease, it is seen as a further reason in the decline in quality of the goods. Demonstration effects. When buyers and sellers are believe in show off. Some goods are bought for the purpose of showing off. They have little utility otherwise. The law of demand does not apply such cases. That is, jewelries, diamond jewelry, there is no more demand when price are high. There is less demand due to lower price. There is more demand when price is high, and there is less demand when price is low. The rich people like to demonstrate such item that only they have. They feel the item only they have. And third is ignorance of consumers. Some goods are bought for the purpose of showing off, and in the ignorance of consumer, the consumer usually judges the quality of the commodity from the given price. According to consumer, they feel they treated on the basis of their own experience. Price is high, that means the goods is under the qualitative. A low price commodity is considered as an inferior and less quality in purchase. A high price commodity is treated as superior and more quantity is purchased. The law of demand does not apply on that type of goods or services. And fourth, in the case of less supply, the law of demand does not work when there is perception of the less supply in the future of commodity. People buy more stock for the future purpose or think about the high price. They think that commodity will become short in supply in the future. Depression conditions, the law of demand does not work during period of depression. The price of commodity are low, but there is increases in demand. It is due of low purchasing power of the people. And next one, in case of given commodities, the demanded of given commodities is decreasing with the fall in price because they believe in superior goods. And next one, possibility to change in price of a commodity. When it is believed that the price is good in going in increase in future, then people start buying more for the goods in present, even though the price are very high position. In case of out of fashion, the law of demand is not applicable in this case of goods that have gone out of the fashion. The decrease in price cannot raise the demand. That type of goods out of fashion, the consumer no need to, or they not want to purchase more. The quality purchase less, the quantity purchase less, even though there is fall in price. Demanded of necessaries. When price of necessaries increase, people continue to buy them even at increased price. That is bread, salt, vegetable, etc. In case of expenditure on goods being a small fraction of the total expenditure, when money spent on a commodity is a very small fraction of the income, increase in price has no impact on demand. A special brand means when a consumer is addicted for the particular name, particular company, particular brand, or a popular brand, they want to continue buy that brand goods even when prices increases. These are the exceptions. So I have delivered today what is the law of demand, assumptions and exceptions. Thank you.